welcome to the stew. It's always a fun time just walking out here. Yeah. You absolutely gotta love it, right?
Red carpet.
Welcome once again. I am Les.
I'm Nene.
And I'm Fern.
Fern with us once again as our guest co-host. And this is the month of October, which is Breast Cancer Awareness Month. So we are wearing our shades of pink and its relatives to honor Breast Cancer Awareness Month. And we're going to be talking all about breast cancer awareness today. And we have a special guest who will be performing a spoken word piece. So stay tuned for that.
Awesome. So yeah. With Breast Cancer Awareness Month right upon us, it's so important for us to spread what are the things that women should be doing, especially in the month of October, to know their status.
Yes.
And when we say status, we definitely want you to know, are there any lumps there and is there any danger lying ahead? Mm-hmm. So things that you must do. The first thing that every woman should do is get a mammogram, of course. Yes. So a mammogram, the process of actually going to places like the 4th Center Diagnostic Center.
Yes.
Is that right?
4th Terrace.
4th Terrace. What did I say? 4th Center?
4th
Terrace. Diagnostic Center. I don't know. And, you know, booking an appointment and actually going there. So, and like Fern said last episode, if you are an Island Luck customer, you are in special, special luck. You have special luck. It's lucky, lucky. You're lucky. It's Island Luck. Duh. So you can take your card there and get a free mammogram. How amazing is that?
Yeah.
You can also visit Doctor's Hospital and also visit the walk-in clinic on Collins Avenue. They also are doing breast cancer
mammograms.
With my
Island Luck card? You serious?
Not with Island Luck. But they do have specials that are going on. They slash the rates. Women, you have so many options now. So let's do this. Yeah. They recommend you to start at age 18 and up.
Yes. Yeah, and I find that so surprising too, because when I was growing up, that number was actually at the age of about 40.
Yes, 40.
And every time I turn around, it seems like the number keeps going down and down and decreasing. Mm-hmm. So ladies, you know, save the tatas, right? Yeah. That's what it's all about. Do yourself breast exams to make sure that there are no irregularities, tongue twister there, and you're just, you know, you're up to date with what's happening with your own body. There's nothing like, you know, being absolutely informed about what's happening with yourself, and so that you're not caught off guard. You know, you absolutely know what's happening, and if there's anything that's different that wasn't there before. Yeah. So
and it's interestingly enough, in the Bahamas, it's just even more important because we, as women, most of us carry the gene or that gene.
The BRCA gene.
Exactly. Yeah. That can lead to breast cancer. So I think where it may not be as pertinent in other places, in other countries, is definitely crucial here that women of, you know, as young as 18, maybe even a little bit younger, go and get tested. Yeah. The statistics are quite alarming.
It's alarming.
Funny enough, just coming across an article all the way back from 2013. We're talking 4 years ago. At that time, the Bahamas was ranking amongst the top 20 nations in the world as far as the high incidence of breast cancer. Mm-hmm. So we're sure that, at least, let me put it this way. From a conversation we had last year with Dr. Darville, the numbers were still pretty high.
Yes.
You know, we haven't, unfortunately, been doing a good job in this country with keeping up with the statistics. Mm-hmm. I do remember that was something that we discussed with her as well. So, you know, our hope is that we can do a little better. Mm-hmm. Individuals can hopefully get to the stage where people can go to a website, if anything, and see what's happening in terms of the numbers. Yeah. Because what you don't know, you just don't know, unfortunately. Exactly.
And the next step now for you, we encourage you to text your mom, your auntie, your cousin, your sister, yourself. You can text yourself these days too. And, you know, tell them to get tested to save the tatas.
Save the Tatas.
So in the spirit of this breast cancer awareness conversation, as I mentioned, we have a spoken word artist coming up on the other side of the break. She's going to be talking about the strength of a woman and, you know, just rising, all right? I'd like to say from the ashes, but I don't want to give anything away, and then I don't want to say nothing that ain't going to actually happen. So you don't go anywhere. Stay with us, and we'll see you after this break.
Yeah.
You are watching The Stew, and here to perform an original piece, we have Princess Abdiel.
She is a survivor. Bougainvillea blossoming on a rust-stained, tattered fence. A timeline of hurts and loss wrapped in a blanket of resilience, hope, and optimism. She is a seeker, analyzing and decoding mythos and parables taught to those before her, those that refuse to trust their intuition and shift their paradigms. She is a healer, tapping into her innate powers to overcome self-conflicts, using the power of love as her magic elixir. She is a believer, manifesting the desires of her many passions, painting her canvas with the sweetest and happiest of her dreams, trusting that the universe will vibrate to her frequency and align her by the direction of the stars. She is a seer, traversing parallel worlds, experiencing deja vu, intuitively moving forward with each next step, lessening mistakes, vibrating even higher. She is passionate, driven by doses of explosive ecstasy, the fountains of flame and lust that set her mind, body, and soul on fire. She is a lover, soft and sharp like lightning, loud as thunder, wet as rain, hot, enriching and life-sustaining like the sun, cool, dazzling, and practical like the wonder of the moon, therapeutic like the sound of music. She is a fighter, a rebel for unconditional love, truth, justice, sovereignty, mental, cultural, psychological, and spiritual freedom. She is balance, junglist on purpose, Caribbean bad gal, goddess, queen, conscious, illuminated, awakened. She is a builder, carving a hole to the bottom of the barrel so the crabs can no longer hole and are free to live and thrive in their natural habitat, inspiring community upliftment through culture and acceptance of self and respect for fellow beings. She is a dancer, gyrating to life through the rhythms of her own drums and others that make her electromagnetic field pulse into higher frequencies and dimensions, expressing movement and the flow of life's tides through her Caribbean stride. She is a poet, intoxicated by words and sentences that stimulate the very essence of her being, immortalizing the people and memories with colorful and flavorful descriptions that teach her a new meaning of life and give her a new feeling of love. She is humble. She is joyful. She is grateful. She is sensually, spiritually, culturally me. She is not of this world. She is from another world, an other world, otherworldly. She descends from the guardian felines who rule for 9 lives. They call her by their chosen name, Bast, Nefer, Sakmet Ka. Guided by the Igun, she is fearless. The depths of her mind leads to the oceans of the middle world, another world, her other world, a world where intimidation, motivation, and inspiration parallels with grace, sensuality, and celestially divine feminine power. Oshun, her wisdom tastes of beast-encoded honey to the tongue, hard to swallow, but sweet and necessary nourishment for the soul. Her eyes see that which we do not see, and her ears hear that which we do not hear. She dreams in spirit and manifests through movement, movement of body yoked with breath. Asana by asana, she constructs, deconstructs, and constructs again. Strong and poised like the flamingo, ascending and illuminating like the bright morning star. She is Venus reawakened.
Wow. Powerful.
Absolutely.
Thank you, ladies.
Amazing.
Thank you, Les. Thank you.
I really appreciate every single piece of myself.
Thank you. And that's why I wrote it, you know, because I wanted to invoke feeling, like strong feeling, so you can feel your strength and power as a woman. You know?
I felt that. I felt your pull. I was like, wow. Yes. I was surprised. Great that talent.
Thank you.
And we really appreciate you being here. And we have more with the princess after this break. You're watching this too. Don't go anywhere. Just had the pleasure of witnessing. You basically can't be a part of the spoken word community here in Nassau without knowing Princess Abdiel. And we have the pleasure of having her with us now on the couch to tell us about her journey into this world and how it got to be that she is so talented. Please welcome Princess. You're like a model beauty queen straightening out hair.
Thank you. You ladies look beautiful,
well,
by the way.
Well, you look
That's
amazing.
What I'm saying. Yes. This outfit is just amazing.
Thank you. And I know for a very long time. Oh, that's so good. Okay.
So you're a part of this movement. I call it a movement because there are a lot of individuals that love their spoken word. Mm-hmm. And Expressions is the name of the group or the organization that you're with.
Well, Expressions is the name of my event.
Of your event?
That is held at Bistro Underground.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
And it's held every second Wednesday of the month. Mm-hmm. So initially, it started off as just spoken word. The vision that we had was just for it to be spoken word because there were a lot of open mics around town that catered to, you know, singers and rappers and musicians, and none really catered to poetry and the spoken word and the art of storytelling. Mm-hmm. So we wanted to create an event that encompassed all of that. Okay. However, spoken word is still, you know, growing.
Yes.
You know, there are persons that are still fine-tuning their craft and that are still, you know, trying to be comfortable with the way that they express themselves. Mm-hmm. And we find that we have more musicians come out. So it's kind of like a blended show now of spoken word and musicians. So it just turned out to be awesome.
Oh, nice. Yeah. So how does one express themselves through spoken word? Like, what would be the first step?
Well, the first step would be to channel your emotions out on paper and write them down, you know, whatever it is that you're feeling at the moment. Mm-hmm. You know, a lot of us can convey our thoughts through speech, yes. through words. Yeah. So, you know, we tend to write. Mm-hmm. So that's actually the first step, you know. Mm-hmm. Just like journaling, you know, mm-hmm. you would mm-hmm. write down what comes to you. And it doesn't necessarily have to rhyme, you know. Right. It just has to just follow a flow, yeah. you know, makes sense.
I noticed, Princess,
or come from the heart.
Yeah. Or come from the heart.
Yes. Yes. Which makes perfect sense. And speaking, though, of coming from the heart, mm-hmm. I notice as you speak, you are very expressive and very fluid.
You know, and coming on the show, I was like,
so I understand.
Try not to use so much of your hands, Princess.
She's like, then you come up. But hey, now I understand where expressions comes from.
Yes.
Yeah, because that is you.
Yes.
Have you always been that way, though? Like, did you feel that as a child? Every time you would talk, it's like a performance.
I have, actually. This is how all of this was birthed in me. I was always into writing. I was always into poetry. Yeah. And I actually performed in the National Arts Festival as a child, repeatedly, and I actually loved it. And for a while, I kind of put it down, you know, mm-hmm. growing up, you kind of lose your passion for some of the things that you do. And coming back into the creative industry, because I'm a percussionist with mm-hmm. a band called Ubuntu, and the drumming brought it out of me. Yeah. And so Volume Music Bar used to host a open mic about some 2 years ago, and I had written a song. I had written a piece that ended up becoming a song. Mm. It was produced and performed by Dyson Knight.
Okay.
And so I turned it into a spoken word, and I performed it at Volume, and that was the birth of it for me.
Wow.
Yeah.
Awesome. From since I knew you, mm-hmm. you have always been so creative. And I heard you said something that's so amazing. It came to you mm-hmm. after doing these things. Mm-hmm. Would you say you've always had it? And then would you say...
I've always had it. But, you know, throughout life, we hit, you know, certain points that kind of, you know, just suppress things.
Yeah,
and then we end up reaching peaks that just overflows it, you know, that just makes it explode. Yes. So that's kind of what happened for me, you know. And it happened at an unexpected time, too.
Right,
so
right.
It was like, while I'm feeling this and while, you know, I have this energy, it should be good to put it out there and just see what comes from it.
Wow.
Yeah.
And what's next for you then? What, where do you want to go with your spoken word at this point?
Well, for expressions, mainly because expressions has grown. So it has grown to be an event.
Yes.
I mean, I didn't think that people would want to come out on a Wednesday night. Mm-hmm. And it's funny, when we started at 9 o'clock.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, Bahamians would come out late. They wouldn't come out until 10. So we put it to 8. And now people are coming out.
Okay.
And we have a whole movement of artists now coming up.
Yeah.
You know, musicians, creatives, and people want a place to share their mm-hmm. art,
just
you know?
Let it out.
And so that's mm-hmm. what Expressions has become. And so I would like to see it grow even bigger.
Right.
I would actually like to see it become a live show like Def Jam Poetry, you know, so others could see the talent mm-hmm. that we have here in the Bahamas.
That's awesome.
So speaking of this then, do you think anybody can do the spoken word? Is it like singing, that either you have it or you don't, or like dancing, you know, you were born with it? Or could any one of us just do it?
I think anybody can do spoken word, because like I said, for me, it's storytelling, and we all have stories to tell,
right?
You know, and we express ourselves in different ways, you know, in our own unique individual ways, and however that chooses to come out, you know, you should just let it come out.
Wow.
Yeah. Awesome.
It could definitely help with some anger management issues in our country,
could.
Right?
Yeah,
so
definitely
tell us,
could.
Before we go, where can we find you guys again? Give us the time, the place.
So every Wednesday, every second Wednesday, we are at Bistro Underground. That is downtown. And we start, you could come at 8 o'clock mm-hmm. and just sit and mingle until the show starts to let it go. And enjoy some of the performances we have.
Yes.
What I usually try to do is I try to feature an up up-and-coming Bahamian artists every mm-hmm. other week. Okay. So this past Wednesday, I had an all-female dynamic trio. You know, these ladies, I mean, I should be paying to see them. You know, I should be paying to see them. But that's what Expressions is. You know, it's a concert. It's a concert. It's a... It's just a big event of everything creative and magical.
Oh, that's awesome. And we surely do love creatives here on The Stew. So we want to thank you for coming out
and speaking
with us.
Thank you so much.
And what an incredible, incredible spoken word
you
have.
Thank you.
We're so happy you're here. So after this, we've got more Stew. Don't miss it.
Welcome back to The Stew.
We had such an awesome episode, Fern. We want to thank Princess for her beautiful spoken word. Remember to continue to follow us on Instagram, ILTV Studios, on Facebook, The Stew Daytime, and we're also on YouTube. You can catch up on all the episodes that you may have missed.
And yes, before we completely say goodbye, we just want to remind all of you ladies out there, go and get your mammograms if you are an Island Luck customer. Fourth Terrace Diagnostic Center on Collins Avenue, and of course, Fourth Terrace is allowing you to just take in your Island Luck card and you can get a free mammogram. Save the tatas, ladies.
That's right.
You with me?
Yes. Save them. And with that, we will see you next time.
You're watching The Stew.